One of the most important tools that you'll need to know about as we start rigging in Rive is the bone tool. Bones allow you to create a skeleton for your graphics. This is an intuitive and natural way to animate multiple connected parts, such as an arm, flag, or tree branch. Let's start by creating some bones. We can activate the bone tool using the bone menu, or by using the shortcut, which is the B key. Once activated, you'll notice that your mouse cursor changes, letting you know that the bone tool is active. To start creating bones, click on your artboard, and you'll notice that the first bone that you're creating is highlighted in blue, and it also follows the cursor. That means that we haven't quite added the bone yet. But the second time that we click, you'll notice that it turns gray and pops up in the hierarchy. Each subsequent click allows us to add another bone to our bone chain. Note that each additional bone that you add is a child of the previous bone. Once you're happy with your bone chain, either hit escape or the V key to confirm your bone chain. In this particular case, we have four bones in our chain, and if we go to the hierarchy and begin expanding that chain, you'll see that we also have four bones, each bone being a child of the previous bone. Now, there's two types of bones. There's root bones and child bones. The main difference is that the root bone has a position property, while the children do not. If you want to add additional bones to a chain, you just need to select a joint, reactivate your bone tool, and begin placing more bones. Note that you can do this from any joint in the chain. It's important to note that joints don't actually appear in the hierarchy at all. These are controls that help us set up and orient our bones. You'll notice that as we move the joint, we're changing both the rotation and length of the bone. The same is true for any joint in the chain. You'll notice that once again, we're changing the rotation and length of this bone while this bone remains the same. Like many other objects, we can create hierarchical relationships between our bone chains. For example, we can add this bone chain to this bone chain down here by selecting the first and then dragging and dropping it onto the bone that we want. Now, when we rotate this bone, it's the parent of these two bones here. These bones also retain their transform space, meaning we can rotate those or reposition them relative to the parent. In the next two videos, we'll see how we can connect our artwork to these bones to deform both vector and raster images.